Hello everyone, and welcome to the CSS Security mini briefing where we will present a short summary of what was released today, August 8th, 2023. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. We're going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then we'll dive into a few vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities we are covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. So before I dig into today's release, I'd like to compare it to the previous 12 months. And with that, we have a total of 76 new CVEs that were addressed in today's release. We've been averaging around 82 over the past 13 months. When we look at scoring, we'll see that the highest rated CVSS score is 9.8 on a scale of 10. CVSS is the Common Vulnerability Scoring System. It's an industry standard scoring methodology that allows vendors to compare different vulnerabilities across different products or even across different vendors. The average score across the entire release is 7.33, which is exactly the average that we've been seeing over the past 13 months. Next, I'll talk about remote code execution vulnerabilities. These are the type of vulnerabilities that typically have the most risk associated with them. These would allow a threat actor to install software or do other malicious deeds. We've been averaging right around 28 vulnerabilities over the past year or so, 13 months. And this month, we have a total of 23 that are remote code execution vulnerabilities that were addressed in today's release. We've been averaging just under one vulnerability that was publicly disclosed prior to release, and in this set, there are no CVEs that were publicly disclosed. And finally, we've been averaging around just over 1.5 vulnerabilities that are known to be exploited at the time of release, and this month we have 0 that fit into that category. Next, we'll look at our overview chart, where those of you familiar with this video, you'll recognize this, where we put Windows products towards the bottom half of the slide and then move up into products that we don't service every month. This month is no different. And as we can see, we're averaging in the mid-30s or mid-20s, depending on the different operating system in question. And we've been averaging mid-30s to mid-40s, so a little bit lower than our average when it comes to the operating system vulnerabilities. Microsoft Office has 10 vulnerabilities that are addressed this month. Microsoft Exchange Server has a handful. We'll talk about one of those in a few minutes. .NET Framework, ASP.NET, Visual Studio, .NET 6, and .NET 7, those are our developer tools, and those have some vulnerabilities this month. Dynamics 365, SQL Server have a couple of vulnerabilities. Windows Defender has a vulnerability, and rounding it out, Azure DevOps Server. So the first vulnerability that I'll talk to today is CVE-2023-36884. This is a remote code execution in Windows Search, listed as important severity. This vulnerability first was published as part of the July 2023 release, and when the CVE was initially published, there were no updates available for it. Now, today, there are updates for Windows, so that closes the loop on this issue. It says a base score of 7.5. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is high. Privileges required is none, and user interaction here is required. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability. And as far as affected software, it's all versions of Windows that are in mainstream support, whether it's Windows 10 or 11 or Server 2012 up through the latest Server 2022. All right, so let's take a look at the first vulnerability from the August release. And this is CVE-2023-36910. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability privately disclosed to Microsoft with no exploitation out in the wild. This one has a base score of 9.8 on that scale of 10, so certainly quite elevated. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. Privileges required is none. And user interaction here is also none. Now, one thing I will point out here is that the Windows message queuing service is not installed by default. So by default, a Windows system is not vulnerable to this issue. You're only vulnerable if you have Windows queuing service installed and running on a system. And so we do have that listed down there as a mitigation. There are no known workarounds for this as far as affected software. It's all versions of Windows that are in support, whether it's Windows 10 and 11 or Server 2012 up through the latest Server 2022. Next, I'll talk to CVE-2023-29328. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability in Microsoft Teams. This is privately disclosed to Microsoft and no known exploits out in the wild. This has a base score of 8.8 on that scale of 10. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. Privileges required is none, and user interaction here is required. As far as the interaction that would have to occur here to be vulnerable is that a user would have to join a malicious Microsoft Teams meeting that's set up by the attacker. I'll also point out that an attacker would be required to trick the victim into joining that Teams meeting, and the attacker does not need any kind of privileges to attempt to exploit that vulnerability. And depending on your product, you might not have any action items in order to update your systems. For example, the desktop on Windows version will update automatically in the background. And I know on my iOS device, I have it set up to update automatically. So depending on your configuration, you might not have any actions. But again, I want to make everyone aware that there is this vulnerability that was mitigated in this month's release. And finally, the last vulnerability that I will talk to today is CVE-2023-21709. This is an elevation of privilege vulnerability in Exchange Server. This is listed as an important severity, privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a base score of 9.8, again on that scale of 10, so certainly elevated. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. No privileges are required, but user interaction here is required. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this. However, there's some extra steps that you're going to need to run in order to fully protect yourself from this vulnerability. And essentially, that's to run a script there or a PowerShell command. That specific script is available in the CVE article, as well as the PowerShell commands if you'd like to just run them directly. A couple things I'll point out about this. Like all Exchange vulnerabilities and security updates, the path here is to first be on a supported version of Exchange Server and then install the security update on top of it. So there's only three versions of Exchange Server that are listed. It's Exchange Server 2019 CU12, 2019 CU13, and 2016 CU23. And if you're not on one of those versions of Exchange, it means you're not on a supported version of Exchange, and you won't be able to install this security update into your environment. So it's imperative that you maintain your Exchange Server infrastructure to always be on a supported version, support a cumulative update of Exchange. That way, when these security updates come out, you can install them on top of the cumulative update. So again, the order of operations here, make sure you're on a supportive version of Exchange, then install the security update, and then run the script or the commands that are listed in the CVE article. All right. Well, that brings us to a close for today. I want to thank everyone for listening to me drone on about vulnerabilities. I appreciate you listening in, and I'll talk to you all next month. Thank you.